It is 10 months since the car crash in Paris which killed Princess Diana, Dodi Fayed, and their driver, Henri Paul. Still, every day, mourners come to the Pont d'Alma to pay their respects. But also visible is a cocktail of conspiracy theories about her death. There is no more fervent promoter of these theories than Mohammed Fayed, the man who claims Diana would have become his daughter-in-law.
He is convinced that this was a plot, this was a murder plot, and that it was hatched by, it's not very precise when you try to pin him down to details, but basically by the royal family, by the British establishment, but by MI6.
Fayed has spent enormous sums in search of evidence of a plot, and he has encouraged the spread of conspiracy theories throughout the world.
We're looking at something that really should not be characterized as a traffic accident case, but ought to be characterized as an investigation into something that, in my view, looks like a murder.
But tonight, dispatches will show that the truth about Diana's death lies not in conspiracy theories, but in a failure of security at the Ritz Hotel in Paris, owned by Mohammed Fayed. And we reveal the mystery figure who says he handed the keys of the Mercedes to the driver, Henri Paul, for the last fatal drive.
Here is the Mercedes arriving on the wheel, and here is Mr. Paul, and he's looking at the photographs. Here is the princess.
He is a 28-year-old chauffeur who worked at the Ritz until a fortnight ago. He is the first Ritz employee to speak publicly about what happened that night, and one of the last people to see Diana alive before she started her last journey. The chauffeur has vital new evidence. Ever since the crash, Fayed's publicity machine has denied that Paul drove off at high speed, having issued a challenge to waiting photographers that they would never catch him. The chauffeur's testimony flatly contradicts that account.
He told to the photographer, don't try to follow us. You'll never catch us. That's what I remember he said to the photographer.
And when he started driving, did he drive normally? Did he drive fast?
They left very fast.
We have also obtained details of a statement made to French police by a Ritz barman, Alain Villomez, which confirms beyond doubt that Henri Paul was clearly seen drinking that night. Villomez says he was told to cover up Paul's drinking for the good of the royal family. And tonight we will document in detail how Mohammed Fayed courted Princess Diana and how the security provided by Fayed failed to protect Diana on the night of her death.
Compared with the protection that Fayed affords himself, which was very professional, of a very high standard, that which was afforded to the mother of the future King of England, to the Princess of Wales, was not up to that very high standard. It was a Mickey Mouse operation that occurred in France.
Mohammed Fayed has for many years cultivated royalty, but he has been less successful with governments that have refused him British nationality.
I think basically he wanted to get closeness to the British royal family, to the British government, so he can use the to influence them for his nationality.
Princess Diana was a frequent visitor to the Harrods department store, which is owned by Fayed. Sometimes she arrived officially, sometimes unannounced. For 8 years, Bob Loftus was Harrods' head of security. As we'll discover later, telephone calls inside Fayed's establishments were regularly tapped and recorded. This call shows what used to happen when Princess Diana paid an impromptu visit to Harrods.
Hello, Mr. Loftus. I'm just phoning up to inform you that Lady Diana and the two children are walking around the store now, just in case you need to know.
Yeah, thank you very much.
Okay.
Yeah.
Bye.
Bye.
I was present on many occasions when Princess Diana pitched up at Harrods, and the moment she was in the store, the same as with many other people that were deemed in Fayed's eyes to be important, and by important that was important to him, it was my duty to inform his personal assistant or his private secretary, and then he would want directions as to where she was, and then he would come down onto the shop floor and meet up with her just to pass the time of day. Invariably, that would result in an invitation to join him for tea or whatever in his suite of offices.
And it was made to look coincidental, as if he just happened to be walking around Harrods and there she was.
Absolutely.
Al Fayed further ingratiated himself by supporting causes close to the princess's heart. He sponsored the English National Ballet and gave generously to at least three of the five charities of which Diana was patron last year. He also harboured an ambition to entertain her on a summer holiday. On June the 3rd, he invited her to join him in the south of France. 8 days later, she accepted.
Here was a rich man with a jolly, apparently jolly nature, of immense generosity, offering her boat and every possible enjoyment on a holiday. And, you know, she was really a sitting duck.
Al Fayed began to make lavish preparations for Princess Diana's summer holiday. The day after she accepted his invitation, he completed the purchase of a new $20 million boat, the Jonical.
Well, normally, as a Middle Easterner, if you have a VIP visiting, you make a special effort to accommodate him. But I think in this case, the special effort to get a boat for $20 million has other meanings than the IC's.
And what do you think those meanings might be?
To over-impress.